Hey, Robert Starr here. I thought you and I could spend some time together today in a massive week for ChatGPT. Now, if you haven't come across it, the acronym is Generative Pre-trained Transformer. Finally got that right. And first and foremost, this is not an AI version of me. This is definitely me in the flesh, but I thought it would be a nice accompaniment to the article that's below this video right now. This week's been like no other. It's the most massively adopted technology product in 21st century and 20th, I guess, human history. In its being able to gather about 1.5 million users inside the first 6 days, which is just a remarkable thing. Now, you might be asking yourself, what is it? Well, in, I guess, simplest terms, the way I've come across this is that it looks like it may be Google 2.0. It may be what replaces Google. Google's definitely aware of it, as we'll talk about in this short video right now. So I guess AI and pharmacy have been something that I've certainly been talking about for quite a while now. And I guess it always has been, you know, how does this apply to us? And it could be things that edit our grammar, for example. It could be things that edit our videos. It could be a whole range of things that look into our data as pharmacists. I know a group called Strong Room AI have made that their mission, and it's a great one, and it's certainly akin to the themes that have been building and building upon this week. And it's something that will not go away. It's accelerating at a rapid rate of knots. And the best way to actually explore what it does is to actually download it. Now, I don't get anything out of this. I don't work for OpenAI. I don't have investments in it, so I'll say that first and foremost. But that's been, I guess, the way I've crash-tested tools across the journey. And it's the way that if you want to get to know what ChatGPT actually is, it's the best way to actually find out. Now, it's very conversational, as you'd expect, with a product called Chat. But you can ask it to do a whole range of things. You can ask it to write an article, interestingly, and if you read to the bottom of this article, you'll be definitely in for a surprise. But the interesting thing about that type of, task is that it's been something that's, yes, humans have been doing for a long period of time. And we're starting to come to this realization that knowledge work and certain set of skills that we have as humans may be starting to become less valued. And it's something that we can always leverage technology. One of our greatest aims in our pharmacy practice is to leverage technology to create deeper, more meaningful patient relationships using this technology. And this is just another step in that journey for us to work out the best way we can integrate this into pharmacy practice. But the best thing to do is to open a conversation with ChatGPT, as I'm sure you will, and learn a bit about it. And I guess some of the applications that we could be looking at in the future of pharmacy practice. Some of these pictures that you'll be seeing around here have been generated by another OpenAI product called DALL-E, and what it thinks the pharmacy of the future may look like, which is quite an interesting thing to get a AI engine's view on that, which I'm definitely something that certainly piqued my interest. And I guess what we were looking at there is, I guess, how this will intersect with our best practice workflows. In my view, technology is always something that is going to enhance and grow a pharmacist's capabilities. And I do see that as being something that we can look forward to with things like ChatGPT. I'm going to trip myself up, I know. But the way in which we look at that is one of the things that's been fleshed out, as you'll read below, is also the ability for ChatGPT to talk to our patients and to get the context of our data, for example, prescriptions remaining, so that questions can be asked in natural human language, as our patients would do. Do I have any repeats left? Have I got any? This is my last repeat. Do I need a new prescription? And it can actually look up a patient's data file, assuming it can be integrated correctly, to be able to provide that information back in natural language, which is just a great thing to do. And certainly, as pharmacist myself, it's something that we would certainly love to get that assistance with moving forward. The number of times where we may have had phone calls where just simply is to find out what prescriptions are remaining on file. It's something that may enhance our greatest talents so that we're spending more time looking into more complex medication management issues than simply what's remaining on file, digital or otherwise. So I can see it being a great partnership. As with everything, there is always, I guess, a caveat in terms of how it will work and make sure that information is always correct. But it is something that will work with the right programming, with the right algorithms to enhance our patient experience. So, let's open the doorways to this conversation. It's one that has certainly come at a rapid rate of knots this week. And I look forward to hearing how you found ChatGPT in your travels and what you plan on using it in your pharmacy practice moving forward. Have a great day. Bye for now.